Looking to turn some old cards into new fetch lands? Check out channelfireball.com's online buy list. We've got ferociously competitive prices on cards new and old, and we send payments fast via check or PayPal. If you'd prefer to pick up singles, boosters, or even a battle box, we offer a 30% store credit bonus. Head to channelfireball.com/buylist to submit your buy order, and soon you'll be rolling in villainous wealth.
Hello there. TWoo here. From Channel Fireball, serious topic today as we discuss the whale species in Magic the Gathering. As we know it, has gone extinct in Standard. There are no whales. Extreme climate shift away from the basic island towards Khan's Trylands, Theros, Temples, and M15 Painlands has left islands in many players' closets, and the whales have gone extinct. Closest remaining whale species here is Scourge of Fleets, as we can see, Love's Islands. So, showing my support today for the basic island, showing my support for the whale and blue underwater type species, rocking a mono Scourge of the Fleets deck today. So, explain where this deck came from and how it works. Flashback to Grand Prix Manchester. Some of you might remember I did well by my standards, with a black-white control deck. Well, sitting down round one, exchanged deck list from the opponent across from me, and their deck had four Dictate of Kruphix, four Scourge of the Fleets, and I asked them to trade decks, and they didn't, and I had to play a tournament with black-white. Now, nobody really knows about this deck because it didn't make top 8 of that tournament, and that was the last block-constructed deck, or block-constructed format. So, didn't get any highlights, but the deck did well at that tournament. It was a counter to the big green decks, really, because the way this deck kind of works is like a turbo fog deck, kind of. What we do is, the idea is just to control, get to a point where everyone's drawing tons of cards with Dictate, but we want to take better advantage of the mana than them. We have Nykthos, which is going to generate a lot of mana with Dictates and our other blue permanents. And we have Scourge of the Fleets, 7 mana, 6-6. Opponent picks up their whole board when it comes into play most of the time, which leads to them having a full hand and having to discard and not make the most of Dictate, or take hits with Master. So in the late game, we can chain multiple Scourges and other bombs. Hypnotic Siren is almost strictly a 7 drop here. Very strong. Steal their best creature, give it +1 and flying. Main addition to this deck to come out of M15 is Aether Spouts. This is pretty great with Dictate, as it's a way to make up multiple cards, fog the board, buy all kinds of time. It's just really good in this deck, and I'm playing 4 because everybody plays creatures. We've got Wall of Frost as an additional way to bog the game down and add Devotion to the board for Nykthos. Master of the Waves is our mid-game finisher. We have Master, Scourge, and Hypnotic Sirens as win conditions, really. And it's great here as usual. It's good in the metagame. There's a lot of red decks that it's solid against. Rockin' Omen Speakers as early game speed bumps, more Devotion for Nykthos and Master of Waves. Couple Slinging Bell Strikes as cheap removal spells with Devotion, although it's not the best with Scourge of the Fleets. And then removal or counter spells in the main, Nullify, Negate, Dissolve. And in long games, these are going to be important for countering removal on our creatures. So this is basically the way the deck plays is like a long control deck, ending with takeovers in the late game. Drawbacks of this deck are it feels really bad. You'll see it feels really bad to get flooded, which happens because sometimes you draw like 30 cards and you might just draw like a lot of lands and it sucks. But other games, you draw 30 cards, and you draw a couple Scourge of the Fleets and a couple Hypnotic Sirens, a couple Master of the Waves, and it's insane. So this deck produces some pretty memorable games where both players are doing crazy stuff. Talk about the sideboard a little bit. Have more counter spells, which is pretty important. against any deck that has removal, especially if they've seen Dictate, because they'll board all their removal, and we have to win a much longer game. Wade through the removal. Got some extra draw, an extra win condition. Biden of Thassa, the forcing your opponent's creatures to attack with either spouse can be good too. Perilous Fault, especially good against Banishing Light. Staff of the Mind, Magus, some life gain. Hall of Triumph is also good against removal, as in a long game, it's like additional Master of Waves, as it protects the elemental tokens from the Masters getting killed. Extra counter spells, Swing Bell Strike, Thassa. And this is it. Like, pretty sweet deck. I like how it plays. It's not necessarily better than the other mono blue deck. It's not necessarily worse. It's different play style, but what I'm trying to do is get the most play and different play experiences out of the same cards. Like, you've seen me pushing Master in all kinds of formats, all kinds of decks. This is definitely a Master Waves deck, but does it feel unique? Absolutely. So what I'm trying to do is stretch these staples as much as possible. Not telling you guys to buy into every one of my decks, but if you buy into one of them that more fits your style, there's a lot of card overlap with other decks that I build, so you can, or other decks you can build, you know, try to make the most out of stretch our cards, right? So this is the deck. Enjoy the matches. There are a few mistakes are made, but it's a pretty good time. So let me know what you think in the comments, and if you have any questions about cards in this deck or advice on how to play it, get at me and I will answer you in the comments. So let's get to the matches. Peace.